Hello, fellow humans of Earth. I've made some decisions recently.
I tried some different things,
and I decided after the last few videos,
I am not going to do this for Bat Buddies on a regular basis on this channel. Now, of course, my life involves making costume items, and it involves talking and corresponding with Bat Buddies. So I can't X that out of my life. But I've resigned myself to the fact that it's not a large enough audience to build a channel and use my time to do that alone. And I got there because I realized, I've been realizing it a long time, but from the last video, I realized no one's really there just because I'm there and want to be there for them. Less than 100. That's great. I appreciate those people, and I'm telling you, my heart goes out to you, and I'm not gonna go away. And I'm grateful, but I can't make a channel built up for such small numbers when it requires a lot of time and really sharing of my life. Like, what I'm gonna do in this video today, I probably would pretty much do anyway. And every day there's something new on this table. And every day I do costuming things, okay? As my hobby. And I also sell some of my items, but I don't try to push for that. I don't try to make myself about that. And you hardly ever hear me mention it. Because it's not about that. And if you've watched enough of my videos, you know it's not about that. However, it needs to be about something new. It needs to be about me and what my whole life is, so that it means enough to me so that I can do it and not worry what the numbers are or what the final outcome is, or be concerned about those things, or even if I ever make a cent on royalties or whatever, I'm not even sure how that works. That doesn't matter. What matters is that what I do is valuable to me to share, no matter how many people care, kind of like conscious counseling. Very few people care about whatever I say with conscious counseling. It even though I believe it's the most valuable thing I possess, it's what I slide down the pole for, as you saw a few videos back. It's what I live for. Very few people, just like Batman, he only goes to save those that need saving. He only apprehends the villains that need apprehending. And the rest of his life is just his life until he goes and does his thing. Well, for me, it's that same way too. But the group that I've been talking with over the years, there's a few that stay there and a few that care about the whole. But because of the way the systems are, of the way, like, it's not bulletin boards anymore, it's not all in one place, it's so hard to be a part of the collective. I am part of the collective by reputation alone and longevity alone. That's not really a lot. It's something, but it's not a lot. It's not enough to build something on. And when I first started this, I thought maybe it would be, but I realize it's not. So I'm gonna do whatever I do, and I'm not gonna apologize for it, and I'm not gonna structure it in a way that, oh, if I don't do certain things that people are interested in, they won't tune in. I'm gonna walk away from that a little bit. That doesn't mean that some people might still occasionally find things that they're interested in. And I might not still be talking to some of the same Bat Buddies. But you'll be forced to be a part of my life a little bit more, whether you like it or not, and you can just turn it off. Turn it off if it's not one you're interested in. But I have to be more true to myself. That being said, I'm going to go ahead and just do one more of these on the table desk series, and I will probably have more of them. And I'm going to do an actual job today, and I'm going to talk about what I'm doing and show you. Today, I'll be taking one of these neck pieces. A few people have told me that, why don't I make these available? Because people might use them. I said, okay, I will, at least in a small way. I'll make them available to the few people that want them. And I'll make that an on the table thing for today. So the first thing I'm gonna do is make sure I have a brush standing by, because the tips on these Plasti-Dip cans aren't as good as they used to be. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. If you shake them well and you're brand new and you got a good tip, and everything is right and all the stars are aligned, you might get a spread that's perfect. lot of times you don't, so stand by with a brush. Now most of your little glittery, shimmery blobs meld in, but if you look at it close and you don't do a rub down, they're still gonna kind of be perceptible. So I keep the brush available. So the first thing I'm gonna do is, I have two of these. I have one right here. This is perfect, and it's thick, holds its shape really well. And I'll probably let that go in the raw form and someone can plasti dip it and paint it however they want with their bat suit. But this one came out a little thinner. I did some different things to the cowl because I wanted a different result. And so it's not what I would call a perfect. There's even a few flaws on it. So what I'm gonna do, oh, this isn't a good tip. What I'm gonna do with this one is create a battle damaged, or not even battle damaged, but battle used, or in the field used look. I talked about this when I was sculpting it. With this particular Arkham Knight look, it really, except for some of the detail areas in the front here, it really doesn't have enough to make it look good without harsh theatrical lighting and some colorized lighting, like from the video game, and some battle scarring and different things like that, creating harsh accents that make it look good. So what you really want to do with the brush to make this better, if it's the look you're going for and it'll match the rest of your outfit, is to give it some of that by hand tooling. Now I did a brief tutorial on this whole cowl. I think it was called the Art Spirit, and you can refer to that if you want to. I got a little heavy-handed because at that time, not heavy-handed, I got heavy-worded. Because at that time, my wife was telling me, you need to do less stuff with the conscious counseling and more being true to your life. And I didn't want to hear that because a part of me wanted to help others and thought that there was some way I could actually make my life about that. But it just isn't coming for me. It's really about whatever I have in the path that's in front of me. And sometimes the path doesn't have that. And I'm going to have to accept that. And I had a talk with my wife today and I said, you know, the shortest days are going to be up to the 23rd of December. It's going to be a little bit cold. So I'm wearing my non-white t-shirt, even though I got my white t-shirt underneath. And during this time, we should think about what are we going to do? But don't do anything big. We got a new world ahead of us here. The next year is going to be a transitional year in so many ways. We had a rough year here. And what are we going to do to redefine ourselves? I mean, we're older, but we can't just go and crawl in a hole. We got to keep doing things. So I said, okay, one of the things I'm going to do is really small potatoes. I'm going to redo a few molds I have. Oh, look, I got this little thing shining back here in case you're wondering what that is. I had that plugged in because if I was going to do some kind of action thing, it would make a thing. But, yeah, ignore it for now. Anyway, I went ahead and got some more silicone. Got a nice box here. And some more resin. I'm just about out. And I'm going to redo some of the molds of some resin things. Now, I've kind of gone away from the resin things because with the processing and everything of eBay stuff and orders and with people on the pie slices cut, a lot of times it's just not worth it. Like if I have a mummy key or something like that. For a while, I was offering things that I would do for my other costuming and say, you can have it too if you want to have that, because I already have it. I'm not going out of my way to make it, but you can have it too. Like, I already had a belt, and I could make more urethane belts, but when they got down to the point where they were just slightly over the cost of materials, it wasn't worth processing it. So I said, okay, what can I do? I've got a bat buddy right now that wants to have this belt that I did last time. I said, well, I want the best for you. And this was made in the video, a few videos back, to be an imperfect. Why would I want the best for you to be an imperfect? So I don't know whether he can do better than me, but I just did that for the video. So he's gonna go and he's gonna take a perfect latex belt and he's gonna make it the best he can. And then if it's imperfect, it's on his hands, whatever he can do with it. But why would I wanna give him an imperfect? That's just crazy. He's a good bat buddy, he's supportive, we have conversations, supports the channel. And he's a good-natured person, and he goes and uses his efforts to do positive things. And I want to inject that. That's one of the reasons why I don't want to totally turn away from this, because then I'd be turning away from all the good things that come from it.
But I can't be all about that. I've got more than enough out there for the time that I've put into this on the 20 documented years since my board and Brotherhood of the Bat. So I don't need to keep being about that. But I'm gonna go ahead and let this dry. Wrong one. Bad tip on that one. I'll tell you another thing too. These tips rarely last. They rarely last the length of the can if you use it on a regular basis rather than all at once. Now, why do I do this? I give it a nice black dark coat. But I've mentioned this in other videos, but sometimes I have to repeat. That's another thing. It tells me I'm doing more than I need of this. If I start repeating, I do this. Who can tell me? Oh, that's another thing. Another video. I've got more videos here I'd like to give away. But I realize people are mostly into streaming and they don't really care about owning anything anymore like that. So I might do more trivia, but a lot of times it's no big deal. Sometimes it's more trouble than it's worth to try to get in touch with the person if they don't make it easy. Like, for instance, a lot of people don't want to put their information on YouTube, and I run my spam filter. A lot of times they can't get through to me. I'm sorry about that. But my word is my bond. If I say I'm going to do something, I will, if you do your part. But if it's so small that it's not that big of a deal, like a video, yeah, let's face it, you can buy videos for $5 off of eBay. It's not that big a deal. Maybe people just let it be. But I'll just tell you, I won't do a trivia question. The reason why I use the Plasti-Dip is for the deep protective finish. And one of the main things is, it's uniform black, and you can further sand it than even the latex and get even better than what you have. No matter how bad your piece is, I could make this a great piece. It doesn't have to be battle damaged. Even with the small things, I could make those small things go away. It could be perfect. But why spend the time? This is not going to generate enough worth to barely pay for the time and the processing of it and the materials. So I'm going to go over this really fast today to show you what can be done quickly. That's what this video is going to be about. Why? Because we need videos about that. Why? Because I need it. And if I need it, you probably do. Maybe you don't. I could be wrong. Okay? So one of the things we're going to do is just give it a little bit of glitz as if lights are shining on it, but not too much. Because I want this to match up with people's suits. I'm always having to switch tips because the tips never last the length of the can. If I go too much like you're in the video game, it won't match people's suits. And few people are going to really go and... Few people are going to really go and make the whole suit like that. So I have to think this is going to end up in somebody's hands and it could be somewhat generic. So I have to think like that when I work, and it's got to be fast. So today I'm going to make this whole thing happen in about 10 minutes. Really crude, but the details are going to come to life. Why? Because the details are raised. They're there. You just can't see them. I want to go a little bit hotter in some areas. I don't want it to be purple, but it's going to be if I'm not careful. So let's dull that down a little bit. A lot of it's going to get dulled down anyway by what I do to it, but basically your basic technique is going to be dry brush. Just like you're doing a painting in dry brush. And you want to do that because we're using a non-conventional material. These are non-expanding paints. So you want to go real light. And if you don't, they'll crack. And you want to build up over a long period of time so that the top parts will gain a little bit of a highlight, but the overall will gain the overall gunking up, if you want to call it, on the surface, so the whole thing becomes its own thing. I want to get into a brushed metal look, but I want the whole thing to have something. I don't want to put battle damage. I want a little heavy hand there, and I got some extra marks on it, more than I would have liked. So I'm going to try to soften that. I'm going to go over it one more time with the Plasti-Dip and do the final hit one more time with the Plasti-Dip blended into it. I've got all those marks softened. Now I'm going to hit it real light and just go over the top, more uniform look. And at the end, I'll come back with a smaller brush and I'll hit those very tips. And I'm going to go over this whole thing now that I know I've got just the right amount on the brush and just let it rub off on those higher surfaces. If you do it enough, you won't need blending. Because the overall doing it causes the blending. Because no one mark is too much for it.
No one mark will leave a huge amount of content of what's on the brush in a place. And suddenly all the recessed areas will show themselves more, and all the protruding areas will capture whatever material they can get off the brush, and they'll come into a highlight. Like I said, I was gonna do this in 10 minutes. Let's try to aim for that. But this isn't gonna generate enough to... Sometimes I'll go like when I first put my brush, I'll go right on the edges, and it's not even bowel damage. It really is just like use damage. It's like, we all love it when you get a new pair of tennis shoes, right? But then as soon as they get scuffed, it's like, oh man, what am I gonna do now? And they don't look good again until I get enough scuffs to make it look lived in, and then all of a sudden it's all right. It's a strange world we live in. But it's good. It's good that way. It's sustainable. It helps us realize that classic things are more important than how great we can live on the edge of whatever our monetary means are. Who wants to do that anyway? How pathetic would we be if those of us that have denied those of us that don't have just so we can be vain? Ugh! See, I'm letting a little bit of my talk about the things I do in other areas of society coming in a little bit. I don't care! Brothers don't want to know this stuff. I don't care. That's what I'm talking about. I've got to be true to myself, even if I'm not giving you exactly what you would like. I let this sit for a little while, a little bit of memory built up right there. I can work that out with the heat or make it bend back the other way. But these are things that we talk about in an imperfect piece that make it an imperfect piece. And we understand that. And it's not necessarily imperfect. A lot of times I'll just say, hey, that looks more lived in, like an old tennis shoe, an old pair of jeans. Nothing's wrong with that. And one of the reasons I've gone this way, and I think a lot of you probably need to go this way too, is because, let's face it, we don't want to spend our last dollar on costuming. I mean, we're getting to the point where a lot of us, even though there's no conventions going on right now, have had the experience over and over again. I was reading one of Tony's posts the other day, and he was saying, actually, I think we're having a conversation, I forget. And he was saying that what he really does more than anything else is live for the moments of doing something for society while he has his costume on. And that touches him more than just the costuming. And I know what he means, because when I first costumed, all that matters, I was costuming. And that goes for a little while, but then you start to say, been there, done that. You either abandon the hobby and you go let that go away, or you say, what else can I do? Well, some people I've found like to do things that they know are valued by the world. And they use it to keep that feeling going that they're a hero, emulating their hero. But they'll go and say, I saw that this had potential way beyond the joy that I originally thought would be of having the public go, oh, look at that, it's Batman, oh, let's take some pictures. And those people are the ones that stay around, and they do more, and they help more. And I'm so glad that I've stayed around and allowed that kind of thing. That's the thing that makes me not want to totally go away from this at all. And I'm gonna call that done. Because now, well, that's a little heavy in the front. Let's just one more time here. A little too silverish in the front. I don't wanna say I'm painted. I wanna say I can be worn with a black suit and it's okay. And of course, you can do this. If this ends up in your hands or one like it, you can do this. Oh, I forgot, the small brush. Basically, at the end, what you want to do is you want to go and you want to talk about just a few areas where the absolute glimmer of light hits it just right. And maybe things that are made out of a different element, too. Little dabs. And again, you want the texture to rub it off. So that what you're doing with the brush is just allowing the texture to do that. You don't want to go in too much because then it says, I'm painted. You know, ideally, you don't want to do that. I went too heavy there. And you want to do this fast. Unless it's yours, take an hour if you want. But what I find a lot of times people do is they work something so much that every part says, I'm this color. Somebody got happy with my spray paint. I'm this color. somebody went overboard. And then you get crackage. I know, when I was younger, I used to think, oh, it looks so good when it's gleaming, it'll be fine. But no, spray paint, by its very nature, doesn't fill in voids. It just provides the color. And so when we treat the spray paint with respect, we get a better outcome. It does what it's supposed to do. It doesn't do things it's not designed to do. And it treats us better and gives us a better overall product. So what I'm doing now is just giving a used, lived-in look by just rubbing a Q-tip on this. You can do this. And I have to do it minimally because I've already got the sculpture. I've already got all that time. I've got the mold making. I've got the casting process. I've got the moving it around, let it wait till it cures. I've got the trimming. I've got the fixing of any problems before I ever even touch it with anything. And then I've got to process this and say, does anybody want this? Because I got too many of them. See what I mean? It gets to the point when the pie is cut so much, you say, ugh, why am I doing this? It's so hard. And if I don't have fun with the hobby, and I render things that have to be gotten rid of, because let's face it, how many pieces do I need? Come on. I got pieces that I don't use. That you have to get it to the point where you're somewhat effective. You have to. And I don't like to push that, come and talk to me about this. It's available. But of course it's available if it's not something I want for myself. But I don't want to be like that. A lot of people are like that, and they have to. Maybe they have to because they have to find their just support that they have to make it worth it to do all that. Hey, let's face it. Look, I bought this. It costs money, right? I have to be able to get that money back. I don't have money to buy things. I buy these. And like I say, one of the reasons why I'm changing this channel a little bit is because I'm not getting enough support to make the hobby fun. 100 or less comments. 100 or less views on a video that doesn't have much to do with Batman shows that nobody's really that interested in just what I have to say or what I do. And that's fine. There's a lot of people out there. Look, Hollywood turns out great entertainment. Why wouldn't you want a team of hundreds of people coming into your living room giving you entertainment? Of course they've got more to offer. My value has always been as an artist how I can do so much as one person. Artsy one. And I want to continue to try to do that. But I can't keep trying to measure my standards based on how I compete with these larger entities. So I realized that what I need to do for the ability to go long term is to not try to do that. It's not realistic. It's not being true to myself. So that's what this video is about. I'd say I spent 10 minutes dabbling with this. That's the final step. Now, what do I gotta do now? I gotta take a picture of it. I gotta maybe edit it or crop it or make it, you know, so that it's presentable. I gotta list it. I gotta see if anybody was right. Yeah, people really do want neck pieces. I'm gonna find out. I'm not going more than two right now. And I gotta see whether it's true. All that to generate a just barely able to get by cost. So that's where the hobby is if you just look at it in the cold bones of it. It's not enough. So I can't make the board about that, because it's not enough. So this video today was about this, but every video won't be. I always have other things on my desk too, like, oh, all the initiatives. I marked them all off, still waiting for the ballots, still waiting for the votes to all be counted to see whether or not what we thought was important for our community was voted for or not. Probably is now, I should check again. I like to go over and say, oh, how close was I to thinking this would be the best? And how close are the people around where I live thinking this is what the best is? You know, I made the mistake, not a mistake, but I got into politics a little bit on the original Brother. I got into politics a little bit on the original Behind the Mask. And we all have different ideas, and you know, it's great to share them. And I was always made to feel like I shouldn't be doing that because it's the bat board, you know? So all the time I was always that way. But I think it's important because you know why? This is why it's important. When we have problems, it's not really a problem. It's an opportunity to make an advancement or to solve a problem. If we try to push it under the rug or pretend it's not there, or just say, I'm going to change my life so that that doesn't matter, well, that's not solving the problem. An artist is all about working the item and solving the problems that any creative vision brings to him. And then hopefully he puts forth something that shows, look, this wouldn't be here if not for me. Look at how I solved these problems. Looking to see whether society sees those things in common with me. It's one of the things that helps me to see, well, how close in unison am I in a major metropolitan area in a very profitable state that has lots of problems still. Some of them aren't being solved right now. There's some problems that are way too big. Hey, whenever I go, yeah, I got a little light there. But what matters is that they're there. And how we approach them, and whether we care and we're empathetic for our fellow human beings, that shows our propensity to even want to acknowledge or solve the problems. I don't want to get too political, but when you're further away from people and problems, it can get to the point where whatever you think you're experiencing, you think is the problem. And a lot of times it's something you have very much not in relation with others. And that's one of the reasons why we have this huge divide. We have one set of people in, just speaking generically here, don't take offense, in more rural areas that aren't so about the problems every day, that they're only more about what they're experiencing, and they tend to find those in commonality with other people like them that are experiencing those problems, and they tweet about them and they post about them, and it starts to be like, yeah, this is solid, this is real, let's all stand on this. But the truth is, and then people are made fun of, like if you're in difficult populated areas and you have homeless problems and things like that, and inequality as far as income, then you have, oh look, they box themselves into a corner. Look at them, they're forced to have these difficulties. And that's what they do, they criticize them. Yeah, well, you know what? The whole world boxed that into the corner, not just them. Nothing's independent, nothing's on an island. But let's not get too much into that. I'm gonna finish up the video. Again, like the artist takes and works something and solves many problems as he works, the human being should be about taking and working the problem and caring and coming out on the other end better, uniformly for all, even though the bumps in the road are there. If my channel was going to be more about what I think and what I do and who I am, it's going to be less about this and more about what I just said, that everybody except those that cared about what I had to say tuned off. So if you're still watching right now, I think you'll be okay with the changes. And that's the people I want to speak to anyway. And a lot of you are going to be probably joined, I hope, my goal is, by people that aren't bad buddies. Maybe not. I don't know. But that's my thought process. So as I say goodbye, right now I'm talking to bat buddies. I'll say goodbye, bat buddies. I'll talk to you soon. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One.